Today we will start general characters of reptile. Here reptilia is a phylum, and these reptilia are first vertebrates which become adapted completely for terrestrial. And here the name reptilia is given by their ability or type of movement. Now these reptiles, they generally crawl, okay, and hence the name is reptilia. Now we will see general characters of these reptilia one by one. Now first, they are terrestrial. All are terrestrial animals. Now the animals or members included in reptilia, they are the first vertebrates which are adopted for complete terrestrial life. Now we had seen in previous topics Pisces, then amphibians. These Pisces, they are truly aquatic. Amphibians, they can live in water as well as on land. Now these reptiles, they are completely evolved on terrestrial or land. Okay, means they require land. Now although we had seen many of animals, they are aquatic. They have aquatic mode of life. Okay, in which, in reptiles, they are terrestrial animals. Okay, completely terrestrial, they live on land, but they have aquatic mode also. As compared to amphibians, in amphibians, what we had studied, amphibians, they live on land as well as water. Okay, they also live on land as well as water, but here the difference or main difference between reptiles and amphibians is, in amphibians they can come on land, but for the process of fertilization they require water or aquatic medium. Therefore they are called as amphibians. Now here in reptiles, they lay their eggs on land. So here important difference is that they require land for fertilization or laying of eggs. They do not require aquatic medium or waters, and hence this is the major difference in between amphibians and reptiles. Okay, we had seen. Then what happens in amphibians? They lay eggs. Their eggs require water medium. Okay, water is present. Now here on land, availability of water is less. Therefore they have amniotic cavity. It is the embryonic membrane which surrounds the embryo or eggs. Okay, suppose this is egg, then they have amniotic cavity, that is embryonic membranes are present, and these membranes, they guard the embryo or simply egg of these reptiles on land from the desiccation. Here as water is less, availability of water is less on land as compared to aquatic medium, hence the embryo is covered by embryonic membrane, and it is the character of, this character is also seen in higher group of animals, further animals and okay. This amniotic cavity is a type of embryonic membrane. Okay. Then, as inland, the skin is dry. Okay. As water is not available, their skin became dry. Then scales are present, scales or spines are present surrounding their body. It is also important character of these reptilian members. The dry skin covered by scales, it reduces water evaporation from the body on land. Hence, water is stored inside their body and the body is kept from desiccation, and hence it helps for the survival on land. Okay, skin. Then the next character, the reptiles are most abundant organisms in their class, but their number is less in compared to another group. Only 5,500 something species are recorded they are live. Okay, the live species number is only 5,000 to 5,500 living species are present. Now these reptiles are present far behind, up to Jurassic or Triassic period. Okay, and here interesting thing is considered about, they are fearing animals. Okay, the most dangerous animals we consider that these are reptiles, but the very few are harmful. Okay, mostly they are harmless. Most animals are harmless. Only few are dangerous, like snakes, etc. But majority is harmless. Okay. Then they are seen. Next, they are seen or mostly found in tropical regions. They are found in tropical regions. In India also, their number of species is more. Majority of species are found or present in India, but their number reduces in temperate regions, that is cold region, and they are not found in Arctic and Antarctic regions. Arctic and Antarctic regions where complete ice cold environment is present, in that environment the reptile species are not found or not inhabiting. Okay, their number is highest in tropical regions. Their number reduces in temperate or subtropical regions, and in north and south poles, their number is not found or they are not suitable for the growth of reptiles. Okay. Then next, they have two pairs of limbs. They have two pairs of limbs, upper limb and lower limb. Now, in some, these limbs are provided with five digits each, and they have horny toes. They have horny toes. But some reptiles, reptiles like snakes, their limbs are reduced or absent. Okay. And in some few reptiles that live in water, the limbs are modified for pedaling or web like structure. Okay, two pairs of limbs are formed. Then next important character, that they are poikilothermic animals. Poikilothermic animals means they do not maintain their body temperature constant. As environmental temperature increases, their body temperature also increases. And if environmental temperature reduces, their body temperature reduces. Therefore, we had seen like crocodiles, etc. In summer days or very hot days, they live in water or they get mud. Okay. And if there is cold, then they come outside the water. They lay on the shores like river shore or sea shores, and mud is covered around their body. Means they get energy or temperature from sun during cold days. Okay, hence they are poikilothermic organism. Now next character is about the herb. Next character is about heart and circulatory system. Now in reptiles, their heart is incompletely four-chambered. In that we can see two auricles are separate and two ventricles are partially separated. Auricles are completely separated, but the two ventricles are partially separated. Now in some other reptiles, these two ventricles, in few cases, they are separated. They are also separated. Now looking towards blood, here the blood contains RBCs which are nucleated. We had studied in human beings, RBCs are non-nucleated. Okay, exactly opposite of human beings or mammals. Their RBCs are nucleated. They are biconvex. RBCs are biconvex. Okay, and here in human beings, RBCs are biconcave. Okay, they are oval and nucleated, as we had seen. Then their bones are completely ossified bones. Completely ossified bones are present in reptiles. Okay. The bones, it includes sternum, complete ribs are present. They have ossified bones. Okay. The ribs are present in chest region, and mostly they have strong skeleton. Endoskeleton is present. Endoskeleton is bony. Okay. Then next point is about respiration. Here respiration occurs through the lungs. It is also important general character of reptiles. In amphibians and pisces, gills are present for the respiration, but here in reptiles, lungs are present for the respiration. In some few reptilians, cloacal respiration is seen. Cloacal respiration is seen like turtles, etc. It is also a type of respiration. Okay. Then next, their cranial nerves, they have 12 pairs of cranial nerves. Kidney is metanephric, 12 pairs of lungs are present. The kidneys are metanephritic. Kidneys are metanephritic. Then, as we had seen, their body temperature is variable. Okay, they are poikilothermic animals. The fertilization is internal, and eggs are produced with large yolk. Fertilization is internal, and eggs with large yolk. To provide nourishment of embryo. These are the certain general characters of class Reptilian.